finished. Game over. Couldn't carry the weight on my shoulders. At my end, in trouble. Knocked down on the ground, seeing double. But then your love, love opened my eyes. Lifted me up, up, now I'm alive. I raise my hands, hands to the sky. Singing oh, 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 oh. Oh, 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 oh. Oh Lord, I'm a different man. You gave me a second chance. I was lost, I was falling apart. But you came along, you hit the restart.
Welcome to my brand new YouTube channel. I am so thrilled that you've chosen to take like just 5 or 10 minutes to be with me. And I just want to encourage you to just follow the segments and stay in order, because each segment will build on the previous segment. So I don't want you to get lost at what I am teaching. But I want to share a scripture, and I want to start off by honoring the Lord Jesus Christ and reading a scripture found in Psalms 138, verse 3. In the day when I cried, you answered me and strengthened me with strength in my soul. This whole channel is about God strengthening me in my soul. I had a battle in my soul, which was my mind. And you're going to learn through Grace Meets Science, this new channel called Factory Reset, where Grace meets science. You're going to learn some very amazing truths about how God wants to take us higher and deeper into His knowledge and His wisdom. Because Isaiah prophesied that wisdom and knowledge would be the stability of our times. And we want to be stable in this day where everything is rocking and reeling. I want to share a little bit of the story of what happened and where the foundation here. Earlier last year, early in spring of last year, I was sitting in this very chair, and when I stood up after reading my devotions for the day, I was dizzy, and it lasted just for a minute or two, and then it was gone. It was fleeting. Later on the day, the same thing happened, and it lasted a minute or two, and then it was gone. The next day, the same thing happened. I got dizzy. I didn't know why. Well, about the third or fourth day, I woke up in the morning and the dizziness just greeted me. I woke up dizzy. I remained dizzy all day long. I told my husband what was going on, and he said, let's go to the urgent care and have your ears checked, because it could be an inner ear infection or something in your ear that's causing your equilibrium to be off. So we go to an urgent care clinic where they checked my ears, no infection. They irrigated my ears. They gave me anti-nausea medicine, which only caused me to sleep. And when I woke up from the sleep, I was still dizzy. So something was definitely wrong. So time passed, a week, 2 weeks, and I'm in this dizzy state, and it was not very pleasant. And the weeks turned into a month. And I remember laying on my couch. I can't even get up to dress for the day. I had to stop driving my car. I had to decline all invitations to go anywhere because I just wasn't able. I was dizzy. So if you can imagine with me going on a merry-go-round or a teacup at Disney World, and you're spinning, 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 and when you get off, that sensation that you have for like 30 to 45 seconds when you get off, that dizzy in your head, that's how I felt 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and it was not letting up. Something was drastically wrong with me. Ended up going to a neurological center in USF in Tampa. My primary doctor sent me to USF, which is USF Tampa Hospital is like the greatest hospital for training and learning and studying on patients. So I went to see a neurologist who thought that when I told him my history of my lung cancer, and if you know my story or read my previous book, you know that I dealt with lung cancer in 2011, where I lost the biggest portion of my left lung. And what happens with lung cancer is it always spreads to the brain. When it won't go anywhere else, it will spread to the brain. So they thought I was dealing with maybe some type of a brain tumor, so the testings began. they tested, the MRI testing showed that there was no brain tumor, so they thought I had multiple sclerosis, which the dizziness is a symptom, a sign of the beginning of multiple sclerosis. So I was tested for that at USF. I was no MS in my body, praise the Lord. They thought I had vascular restriction in my brain stem. So another test after test after test with no conclusion, no answers. It was very disappointing and very hard, a very dark time of my life to lay on my couch day after day and be dizzy, discombobulated, and disoriented. My cognitive skills began to decline so bad. I couldn't even figure out how to put two and two together and to do things. So I did it. I laid on my couch and alone when my husband was at work, alone in my home, just praying the Lord help me. And like the scripture that I read to you in Psalms 138, that I cried to the Lord and I said, strengthen my soul, God. What is it? What's wrong with me? And as I lay there a month into being dizzy, I felt the leading of the Lord to figure out maybe there's something I could possibly eat that would help the organ of my brain, because something definitely is wrong. So I did a little study about foods that would help, and walnuts is one of the greatest things on the top of the list that you can eat that helps your brain. You may even notice that a walnut is shaped like a brain with two hemispheres. It's really amazing. Avocados and spinach and things that from the earth that God made. These are things that we want to put into our body. This is not a nutritional class, but I just wanted to throw that in. That's some things that started me on my journey. About 3 or 4 months later, I'm still dizzy. I had a friend named Maggie from our church who invited me to her life group in her home, which we had been a part of up until I got so dizzy we couldn't attend. But this particular night, Maggie said, we're going to pray for you, Janet, tonight. There's like 10 or 12 people going to be here in my home. And we're also going to pray for Rosemary, which was our dear friend who was dealing with a brain tumor and had surgery and was dealing with chemo therapy. And she came to the life group. And we prayed for her first. And after we prayed for her, I was across the room from her, and I began to share, in a nutshell, what I had been dealing with over the past 3 or 4 months. And when I said about my dizziness, Rosemary, who is a seasoned intercessor, a graceful, very prophetic woman, she pointed at me across the room, and she was trying to speak to me, but because of the brain tumor and the chemo fog, her words, she couldn't get her verbiage out. She could say bits and pieces, but we couldn't understand what she was saying. So she would begin to make hand motions. And over a period of a few minutes, we figured out what she was saying was, she kept saying, I see you, Janet, in a cannon. You're in a cannon. And the fuse down here is lit. And when it reaches the end of the line, I see a launch. Well, if you know anything about a cannon is only room for one person, if that. So definitely, me being alone in my home was like being in a cannon. I was like trapped. I couldn't move. I couldn't go anywhere. I couldn't do anything. I had to quit playing the piano, which I've been playing the piano for 30 or 40 years. I had to quit because I couldn't focus on where the next key was to go to, and I had to stop. I tried to read. I could read maybe 5 minutes maximum. Then I would get so discombobulated I had to stop and lay down again. Definitely in a cannon. So they prayed for me. We got up to leave, and a friend, a dear friend from South Africa, was in our church there. Her name is Glenda. And she took my hands gently and she said, Janet, I hear the words factory reset. She said, I see you like in your mother's womb, and you are fearfully and wonderfully made, and your mind and your brain were perfectly made in its original design, and God is doing a factory reset on you, bringing you back to your original design. That's a powerful word. I took the word in my heart, and I began to ponder it all night long. I wrote it down when I got home, and I wondered, what does the word mean? The next morning was Sunday. My husband helped me into the car, got in the car to go to church, because the only place that I went was to church. And sometimes I had to have people assist me to get my chair because I was so dizzy. I remember going to Sunday morning pre-service prayer that day, and they were going to pray for me specifically because on Monday, the following day, I was going back to Tampa to USF Hospital for further testing on my brain. And so they gathered around me and began to pray, and there was a young lady named Gospel who knelt at my feet there and laid her hands on my knees, and she began to pray the most fervent prayer over me. Then she began to say to me, she said, "Mama Janet, I see you as a tree, and your roots are so deep and soaked in water, and I see the fruit coming up in the tree, and it's beautiful." So there you have it. Within 24 hours, I had three prophetic words given me, and I don't hardly ever get a prophetic word, and when anything that God comes from the Spirit of the Lord, I treasure it in my heart. And I ponder it. Like Mary, when she was told by Gabriel that she was going to bring forth a son, she didn't go blabbing it to everybody. She pondered it in her heart, and she kept it in her heart there. That's kind of what I did. I just kept those things in my heart. And I'm saying, God, what does all that mean? Over a couple of weeks, I found myself opening up my computer again. Just, I thought I was going to study some more about foods. Ended up finding a website about the mind and the brain connection. And I started digging into some college courses and trying to figure out how could I gain this information. And I felt the wind of the Holy Spirit really leading me and just prodding me to enroll in a couple of courses online. I enrolled in psychology through Yale University. I enrolled in neurobiology, which is the study of the actual brain. And I began to study cognitive science, which is the study, the science of thought. So here I am with this battle is in my brain and my mind. So at that point, when I began to enroll in courses, which I can't even cook dinner, but I'm enrolling in college courses, it was so the Lord. I can only study 5-10 minutes, and then I realized that one day that grace met science. Grace met science in my life, and he began to teach me. And if you'll look on the slide presentation on your screen, you will see the picture of the Bible on the left, the picture of science books on the right. And I want to tell you a truth, that science and the Bible have the same author. God created, he wrote the Word of God, he's writing the science books because he created everything. He is the creator. And in this season of my life, I begin to know God as my creator. I knew him as my Lord, my Savior, my baptizer, and all these things, but I never really knew him as creator until this season of my life. So I began to study neuroscience in a dizzy moment. It was wild, but it was the Lord. Follow with me on the screen where it says on the left side that scientia is the Latin word for knowledge. And God is the source of all knowledge. On the right side it says God is everything. He made everything, and science is just a proof of the everything. Therefore, we can admire God through science. And that's what we're going to be doing on these few segments that I film for you, however many that is, that we're going to admire God through neuroscience and the creator, the factory who made us, who made you, who made me. And we're going to get back to our original design by learning how to care for ourselves, our body, our minds, and our brains, and all that's included. So I'm going to pick up where I left off on my next segment. We're going to talk about the three prophetic words that God gave me. And I pray and hope that you will join me back here in my factory reset where grace meets science room. And thank you so much. Thank you, and have a blessed day.